One of the challenges that I hear about often, being part of IT, is the concept of the cloud really isn't that complicated. The idea is just like you're talking about with the iPad. From anywhere in the world, we want to be able to supply you with the information and the tools that you need easily and rapidly. But the cloud, as soon as you get into virtualization and the concept of the cloud into IT, there's a lot of resistance today in IT. Why is IT so afraid of going towards this mechanism that would actually make their lives easier for them?
Because they're afraid they're going to lose their job.
Oh, okay, that's easy.
And it's really the elephant in the room. People will talk about all these reasons why it doesn't make sense. And people will, I think in their heart, in some ways contrive reasons why you shouldn't move to the cloud. Let's look at IT from the very long-term perspective. For a long period of time, IT was in that sort of Wild West mode. Anything goes. We're making up the rules as we go because, you know, if you compare IT to architecture has been around since the first building, right. But IT has only been around for a series of decades at this point. And so the early decades were us just really trying to get our feet underneath us in terms of stabilizing some of the core processes that we have. When you mature those processes, when you stabilize them, they become easy to replicate, to package, and then to make available to you as a service. I mean, you don't grow your own food. You don't raise your own cows anymore for meat. You go to the grocery store because someone's figured out that I can create this experience that is the grocery store. And I can do it at a lesser cost, both in time and dollar cost. So the cloud is in many ways a manifestation of the stabilizing of IT. And it makes a lot of people afraid. You know, there's a kind of an undercurrent story that if the sum total of your contribution to the IT department and your business is clicking the next button, well, we're getting to the time when you really need to start thinking about either evolving what you do or thinking about doing something else. So the cloud scares a lot of people because we can get complacent in our old way of doing things.
It's funny because we hear that a lot on, especially on the PowerShell administrative side, is, you know, if your only value is clicking next, finish, you might want to start thinking about that. You know, now it's actually about real management of large-scale systems. With all of the technologies that are, it seems like they're just appearing, but they've been out there for a while, both from VMware, from Microsoft, even Apple now with their iCloud. Even my spouse is moving her library up into the cloud in this. So it seems like there's an adoption amongst users seem to be okay with it. It's IT that seems to be fighting against it, I guess, on a lot of security grounds. Now, with private clouding options versus public clouding options, what's a great way for an IT person to start to kind of grapple with this and deal with it?
The first thing that you should put in your mind is if anyone is trying to tell you that you should move everything that is your infrastructure into the cloud today, that's not a person you should be talking to. No one with any legitimacy is trying to tell you to move everything into the cloud today. There was a period not long ago when in virtualization, where we thought of this notion of virtual candidacy. So you would go and identify the low-hanging fruit that made sense to virtualize because they were easy and they were low risk. Well, we're kind of at that point now in terms of cloud services. If you go and find those low-hanging fruit where it makes sense to actually cloud enable them or push them into the cloud, it's a good way to get your feet wet for this whole new way of delivering services. And I see a lot of people that are moving into the cloud these days following that model, and it ends up being very low risk for them. They can reap some of the early rewards of cloud. And from an IT person's perspective, you can take a lot of the scut work of IT out from your list of things you need to do. Now, if you're the type of person that just likes to click buttons, well, then this does not exactly help you. But if you're the type of IT person that really desires to help your business out, to really truly help your users and to deliver that experience that the users are looking for, well, the cloud presents an option that you can move towards that does so potentially for lower cost and probably for a better experience in certain circumstances for those users.